Okay, challenge number 11 starts out with this quote, without the spiritual world, the material world is a disheartening blank. And so some of you who have come across this quote know exactly how it ends, but if you're like me, didn't get a really good liberal arts education, you have to rely on Google. Let's search that. And of course, the material world is a disheartening enigma. So immediately you can probably guess that this is an enigma encoded message. And the instruction is to try day hex B. So not only is it enigma, they have to be able to decode what hex B is. And of course this is decimal 11. So day 11. But you need to figure out what the keys are, and so this is where your Enigma key sheet comes in, and this is linked off of the main site as well. So here are the Enigma keys that are given to students, and you see day 1 through 11, and these are the settings here. So now what I need to do is I need to open up a tab with the Enigma emulator in it. And so what I'll do is I'll rip this tab out because I need to set the Enigma machine. And then there's a link to the Enigma emulator on the web page. So you see it down here in the oops, sorry, I got this other dialog up. You see it right here on the page, so I'm going to open that up. So here's our Enigma emulator, and then what I need to do is punch in the keys for day 11. So it's starts with the reflector B, which is set. Then I have 812 as the wheels, so this will be 812, and then for the ring setting, it's SBE, and then the ground settings GZU. So SBEGZU. And then we have all of the plug board settings to enter in. So what I'll do is I've got to make sure I have day 11 on here. So these are them. B goes to T, C goes to H, G goes to V, I goes to K, L goes to S, M goes to U, N goes to Y. Q goes to R, W goes to E, Z goes to A to Z. So when you do Z goes to A, it automatically sets A goes to Z. So, all right. And then what I need to do is, given these settings on the emulator, the Enigma was symmetric, so that the same settings for encryption can be used for decryption, and that's what the reflector was inserted, so that weakened the Enigma, but it allowed the same settings to be used for both encryption and decryption. So now, what I want to do is, because I've been given a block of text, so I can actually get rid of this because I don't need it anymore. So here's the ciphertext. And I know with these settings I can both encrypt and decrypt using the same settings. So I'm going to copy this. And rather than typing these a single letter at a time, because I make typing mistakes quite often, it'll be risky to try and type these exactly into the Enigma. And a typo will basically kill your decryption. Because of the way the system works. So I'm going to just copy and paste this block of text into this dialog box. And then I will encipher slash decipher it. And I can see the message here. The key for number 11 is Greek subterfuge in lowercase. Okay, so that is the key for 11.